creatures on the street. Lift up your eyes to the world you saw, for the Lord of the earth, the Master of the sea, has come. Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
The intentions for Holy Mass this morning, for Elizabeth Folman on her birthday, and for the repose of the soul of Sister Agnes and the deceased members of this community. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
As we prepare to celebrate the sacred mysteries, we ask the Lord for a humble and contrite heart. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, direct our actions according to your good pleasure, that in the name of your beloved Son, we may abound in good works. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Jonah. The word of the Lord came to Jonah, saying, "Arise, go to Nineveh, that great city, and proclaim to it the message that I tell you." So Jonah arose and went to Nineveh, according to the word of the Lord. Now Nineveh was an exceedingly great city, 3 days' journey in breadth. Jonah began to go into the city, going a day's journey, and he cried, "Yet 40 days, and Nineveh shall be overthrown." And the people of Nineveh believed God. They proclaimed a fast and put on sackcloth, from the greatest of them to the least of them. When God saw what they did, how they turned from their evil way, God repented of the evil which he had said he would do to them, and he did not do it. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
O Lord, make me know your ways.
O Lord, make me know your ways.
O Lord, make me know your ways. Teach me your paths. Guide me in your truth and teach me, for you are the God of my salvation.
O Lord, make me know your ways.
Remember your compassion, O Lord, and your merciful love, for they are from of old. In your merciful love, remember me, because of your goodness, O Lord.
Make me know your ways.
Good and upright is the Lord. He shows the way to sinners. He guides the humble in right judgment. To the humble, he teaches his way.
O Lord, make me know your ways.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. I mean, brethren, the appointed time has grown very short. From now on, let those who have wives live as though they had none, and those who mourn as though they were not mourning, and those who rejoice as though they were not rejoicing, and those who buy as though they had no goods, and those who deal with the world as though they had no dealings with it. For the form of this world is passing away. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
kingdom of God is at hand. Repent and believe in the gospel.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
After John the Baptist was arrested, Jesus came into Galilee, preaching the gospel of God and saying, "The time is fulfilled, and the kingdom of God is at hand. Repent and believe in the gospel." And passing along by the Sea of Galilee, he saw Simon and Andrew, the brother of Simon, casting a net in the sea, for they were fishermen. And Jesus said to them, "Follow me, and I will make you become fishers of people." And immediately they left their nets and followed him. And going on a little farther, he saw James, the son of Zebedee, and John, his brother, who were in their boat mending the nets. And immediately he called them. And they left their father Zebedee in the boat with the hired servants and followed him. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord
Jesus Christ. There's something that affects all of us some of the time, and some of us all of the time, and that is putting things off to tomorrow. But tomorrow never comes. Each day we speak about tomorrow, but tomorrow never dies. There's always, in our language, in our thoughts, tomorrow, but tomorrow is another day, not now. People have made all sorts of slogans about tomorrow. Tomorrow belongs to us. But what is happening is we are actually putting things off, postponing things, deferring things. And there's a very common experience. Oh, well, I'll sort this out tomorrow, or I'll clean this room tomorrow, or I'll go and visit the sick tomorrow. I'll do it tomorrow. And very often, of course, tomorrow, and then tomorrow, and then tomorrow, and we end up not doing it at all. This is a nuisance and a bad habit in ordinary life, but it is a disaster in the spiritual life. And it's what Jesus shows us is not his way at all. No procrastination. Jesus, when he calls, he means today. Jesus was just beginning his pastoral ministry and just choosing, calling certain people to assist him, to be with him, and to be sent by him. And if we look carefully at the call of these first four of the apostles, then we see that Jesus takes the initiative. Simon and his brother Andrew were not looking for Jesus. Jesus was looking for them. Likewise, James and John, sons of Zebedee, were busy with their nets, busy with their work. The boat must have been pretty large, full of people, those two. They hired servants and the father, all in the boat, cleaning the nets and getting ready for the next catch. So the initiative in this call is with Jesus. And this is how it works today. He calls us. He searches for us. And he calls ordinary people at their ordinary work, fishing and carpentry and whatever else. And he calls for us to join him and the others. So there is a community. But what is perhaps very striking in today's gospel is the response. Not just the call of Jesus, but the response of these disciples. Simon and Andrew left their nets immediately. They didn't go home first and consult others in the family. They left to follow Jesus immediately. And James and John, even, if you like, more dramatically, leaving their father in the boat to finish the work, and they went and followed him at once. And what are they following him for? Jesus wants to establish the kingdom of God, and he has to call others to help him. And the church has come to see that Jesus himself is the kingdom of God. The kingdom of God is nothing like any earthly kingdom with palaces, crowns, and all that kind of stuff to do with kings and rulers and sovereigns. But it is a spiritual reality which Jesus says lives in people's hearts. And that's why he calls them into a kind of new life. So there is a mystical dimension to the kingdom of God, and there is a church dimension to the kingdom of God here on earth. So the very first sermon of Jesus, as it was the very first sermon of John the Baptist, is repent and believe. Repent and believe the gospel. But it's not repent tomorrow and believe the gospel tomorrow or next week or next month. It's repent now, today, this morning, and believe now, this morning, as we profess our faith in the Eucharist. The heart of Christianity is following Jesus today, not tomorrow. Tomorrow will look after itself. All we have is today, and even that is flimsy and fragile. We don't know if we will see even this day out. But we have now, and this is the moment of truth, the moment of love, the moment of decision to give ourselves to the Lord in our own way, in our own vocation, to the glory of God the Father. Amen. Amen. So let us profess our faith now. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made, for us and for our salvation. He came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and life of the world to come. Amen. Let us pray. Loving Father, we thank you that you have alerted us to the call of your Son to be with him and to be sent out to build the kingdom. Listen now to our prayers made in faith.
That our parish community may proclaim in our work and worship together the reign of God. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That our church may be a place of welcome and refuge for all people. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That our bishops, priests, pastors, and ministers may proclaim the gospel with the perseverance of Jonah and the commitment of Peter, James, and John. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the world's governments and peoples may work together to ensure the just and responsible use of the gifts of the earth. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the grieving, the bitter, the troubled, and the lost may build new lives in the hope proclaimed by Christ. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That our beloved dead may rejoice forever in the fulfillment of the reign of God. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That God will hear the prayers we now speak in the silence of our hearts. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. God of timelessness, Lord of history, hear our prayers. Help us to realize that your gift of time is not the end or limit of this life, but the pathway to the complete and perfect life of the risen one, in whose name we offer these prayers through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. The bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands, to comfort us the bread of life. Mystery of this morning, pray we come to share in the divinity of Christ. Who humbled himself to share in our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. Witness we have received the wine we offer you, the fruit of the vine, and the work of your hands. It will become our spiritual drink. Ask you to receive us and to be pleased with the sacrifice of contrite hearts. Wash away my iniquity, cleanse me from my sin, cleanse me from my sin. So let us pray that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, our loving Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Accept our offerings, O Lord, we pray, and in sanctifying them, grant that they may profit us for salvation through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For when your children were scattered afar by sin, through the blood of your Son and the power of the Spirit, you gathered them again to yourself, that a people formed as one by the unity of the Trinity, made the body of Christ and the temple of the Holy Spirit, might, to the praise of your manifold wisdom, be manifest as the Church. And so in the company of the choirs of angels, we praise you, and with joy we proclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the offering of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Stephen, our Bishop, and Sylvester, his auxiliary, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. At the Saviour's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Bring the bottom part of her. Bring it out. Lord Jesus Christ, with faith. With faith in your love and mercy. And eat your body and drink your blood. Let it not bring me condemnation, but health of mind and body. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter
under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. The body of Christ.
Amen.
The blood of Christ.
Amen.
The body 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 of Christ. Amen. The body of Christ.
Amen.
Amen.
The body of Christ. The body of Christ.
Amen.
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 Look towards the Lord and be radiant. Let your faces not be abashed.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that receiving the grace by which you bring us to new life, we may always glory in your gift through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Mass is ended. Let us go and serve the Lord with our lives.
Thanks be to God.
O Saint Michael, the Archangel, defend us in the day of battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly hosts, by the power of God, thrust into hell Satan, all the evil spirits, wander through the world for the ruin of souls. Amen.
Thank you.